welcome out on stage, Mr. Steve Hewlett. So when I get to the airport, put that for the x-ray, the security don't know who I am because they came forth. So I stand in line at the airport. When it gets to that screen, their faces change because there's people in my box. And they freak out a little bit. And I just stand back and go, help me, let me out the box, anyone there, let me out, help me. Some of you are laughing. They don't laugh at Gatwick at 4 o'clock in the morning last Tuesday. And that's when they took me into that back room, took out a glove. And I found out what it was like to be one of my own puppets. Oh, cheers for that. It's a true story, don't laugh. Anyway, I love doing what I do, but when you do something like Britain's Got Talent, and then you come fourth in the final, all those months to get fourth, I don't mind being fourth. The Stavros Platney came fourth. And look where they are. They're in Cyprus. No, I work there as well. I love those guys. They're brilliant. So, because I came fourth, we're always trying to better ourselves in this business, you know. You want to go back on telly and you want to better your score. So I thought, I'm not going to be fourth next time I go on telly. And it's worth it because people want holiday. And we're here to make them smile.
Yeah. So, what's that down there?
That's the children, the boys and girls, the kids. That's what we're here to entertain, the whole family. So that's the kids, the little one.
Chucky's coming.
Don't say that. No.
Chucky's gonna get here.
Oh, shut up. Don't say that. No, because we're here to entertain, you see. So,
Chucky.
Right, man.
Chuck under the bed.
There's no Chucky under the bed. So, I'm sorry. So, what are we doing? Why are you laughing?
Because no one else is.
They are. But, listen, if you're scared of the younger generation, all you have to do is connect with them the way they connect with each other.
Kids, go home and I'll text you on Fortnite.
Don't be rude, that's me. You see, he knows what we're talking about. So, you talk about their favourite TV shows. That's how we get them, right? We all watch the same stuff. So if you talk about In the Night Garden, the little generation will love you. They will work up the generation. So you talk about In the Night Garden.
Now?
Yes, now.
Chucky's in the Night Garden.
No, he's not. You don't put Chucky in the Night Garden.
Why didn't he go out of the fence?
No, he didn't. Stop it. Listen, I'm going to be aggressive. So, yeah.
Chucky's on the Linky Nunk.
Shut up.
Oh, look up there.
Chucky's now on the Pinky Pong. There's no Chucky on the Pinky Pongy Nunks, right? So, there's also Dora the Explorer.
She can get lost.
She can't get lost. Because she's got a rucksack, and in her rucksack is a sausage roll.
She's been to Greg's.
How does she find it?
They're everywhere.
Right, so, because, right, she's got a map.
She?
Yes, get her life, Dora. It's 2022, get yourself a sack now. Okay, right, so ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to dedicate, listen, you're going to dedicate a song. You can sing for the lady. Now, I'll count to three.
Genius.
When I get to three, you start singing. What about the mums and dads? Don't leave the mums and dads now. How would you connect with them?
Chucky's in Coronation Street.
I don't know. What about the teenagers? You connect with the teenagers?
Yeah.
Cool then.
Can't communicate, the phone battery died. I'm not another, Royal Shower. Love Island, green.
Stop it. Don't typecast teenagers. If you think about it, Arthur, they're our future.
We're doomed.
What about the nannies and granddads, the grandparents?
Chuck is in countdown.
Anyway, what do you tell about last year?
Oh, it was 2021.
And tell him about your news.
Oh yeah, Arthur became a granddad. Sent me home. He stitched me up with a needle and a thread. It all the tears in my eye. When he stuck his hand inside, he gave me life and I thought I was dead.
What are you doing?
This is Friday in Harrods.
Good night.
piece of thing. So just remember, look after yourselves and look after the ones you love. And give her one more big round of applause, my friend, Arthur Lager.
Thank you.
Take care. And remember, she's watching. Watch this. That's definitely moving, isn't it? That's not just me, is it? Yeah. We're not stupid. I'll have a bit of a drink so I get a little hoarse.
That's one of the jokes that I do.
It's not possible. I'm not trying to do your entertainment. You can't pass all fucking now. It's over. Shut it, you lost your bottle.
Yeah, just put some jokes in there, just for hilarity.
And so, ladies and gentlemen,
in here.
Shut up.
I'm in here.
What?
In here.
You're in there?
Yeah.
Hello?
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 Hello? Kiss a kiss.
What? No?
Yes. Kiss me, Steve.
Not kissing you, there's people watching.
Kiss me.
I'm not kissing you.
Just a kiss.
No. Get off. Sorry, Mike. I was looking at someone.
In here.
Ah, it's in there. It tricked my own voice. Tricked me. It's in there because I drunk it. So, not drunk it. That's not the correct English. I drunk it. You drank it. You didn't like it. It's in there. Just get rid of this. That's how you get rid of it, because I'm drunk it anyway. Okay, right.
Still here.
It's gone.
Still here.
Oh, I'm going to bring on now some lovely characters for you. Lovely. So I was in a very romantic restaurant earlier today. Me, myself, and I sat there talking to myself. Because I'm a loner. And I was Molly Allen, and I picked this up off the table. I won't tell you the name of the restaurant, because Butlins have got amazing restaurants. I'll just tell you the initials. It's KFC. And I sat there, and I thought, what can I do with this? Right? I love creating characters and bringing things to life. Sometimes I do it with audiences. So, here we go. I've done that, and then I heard some beautiful music in the background. And I thought, I'd create this little character.
Hey, can I ask a reverb?
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Unforgettable. That's what you are.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Nat King Cole. Stop the music, man! Cut in the laughter. King Cole. Oh, come on. Nap King. I'm moving the lips to do that, but Nap King is an actor. It's Nap King. So you can hear over this side, that's a napkin, and that's it's Nap King Cole. Google it, and it'll be funnier. This doubles up as John Lennon, right? Because it's made of linen, and he's a singer. That's what it's materialistic singers. And you can have lots of fun with this. You started to laugh. That means you started to get it. It's hilarious, right? And you'll probably think I'm wasting your time, but you'll be lying there in your accommodation about 3 o'clock tonight morning, right? Tomorrow morning tonight. Tomorrow. Well, how do you say that when it's still up? Sorry? Tomorrow morning, right? And then you're lying there and you're thinking of these new things. Dolly Tartan. There's another one. Leather Van Dross. Shammy Davis Jr., Shammy Winnett. There's loads of them. Alright, you're not going with it, but you wait. Yeah. You won't be able to sleep now because of that. It's your fault. I'll do one for the younger generation. Hang on. This is Jason Derulo. I told you, you won't let us sleep tonight. And don't forget to tweet me on Facebook, me, and tell me your ones, because I need a better act. This is Jason. How'd you get to be a top of the range toilet roll?
I started at the bottom and I worked my way up.
Is diarrhea hereditary?
Yes, it runs in your genes.
Wait! Say that. I've got to get up early tomorrow.
Yes, I'm getting up the crack of dawn.
No, leave it! I'm sorry if there are any dawns in. That's not dawn on me then. You get the idea though. That's the kind of fun that I have. Over the hours I kill in the car. Anyone got one now? Shout it out if you have. Yes. Shampoo? Yeah! Shampoo? Who's the singer? Jesse Shakeoff, just thought of another one. That's good. Shampoo? There's shampoo? I don't know who's in the charts. There might be a shampoo in the charts. She's washing her hair somewhere. Okay. So, someone called Poo. A chamois leather. Wipe poo up with a chamois leather. I don't know if that's what you talk about. Are you ready? Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to bring my... Now, who remembers Sherry Lewis? Oh, yeah. Who remembers the first to put a Sky dish in your street? You got Sky One, and one of the first shows that came on in the 80s when that happened was Lamb Chop's Play Along. Sherry Lewis and Lamb Chop. This is my version. This is Lamb Shank. Hello? Say hello.
No.
Say hello to everyone.
No, I don't want to.
Lamshack, say hello.
No.
No, it's all right. I'm not going to force you. You can't make him talk. I can. This is my job. Okay, so take it home and laminate it. Don't look sheepish. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Two characters now for the price of one. Please welcome to the stage, Russell and Cheryl! It's the Crows. I came forth and got to write my own stuff. So Russell and Cheryl, wait to entertain this amazing audience by singing a song, the slightly more popular don't song does do some magic. Will you do that for me? What did he say?
He said...
Anyone here speak Croatian? Everyone cut me out! Come on! Here we go, set the stage! Cut me out! Here we go! Was missing from his tours. He should have put that on the end of his hand, and every time he did that during his songs, he went, ow! Should have just had that. Create some laughter as well. See? Al Jarreau, that's one of those. Are your kids lying? That's what I do with that. But it's not all about that, ladies and gentlemen. It's not all about the one-legged chicken. No, it's not. It is about my next guest, who has been travelling the world. He's on a world tour. He started in Skegness tonight. It starts tonight, and it finishes. It finishes in Skegness tonight. It's one night, this tour, so enjoy it. It's a world tour, and it stops right here. He's doing so well, this brand new artist I'm about to introduce you to his wonderful array of music, into blues music. We want to make some blues fans tonight. He's doing so well, I can tell you now, he's got over 135 followers on MySpace. Please welcome to the stage, this is Rock Vegas! Yeah! Well, yeah, it's not plugged in. So this is Rock Vegas. Hey, buddy! Where are we? Butlins. Hey, Butlins! My name's Rock Vegas. But Rod, you used to be in a band. Tell them about your band. You should plug everything while you're up on stage. Tell them about your band. How's it a band? What was it called? We were called the Duvets. Anyone heard of the Duvets? No? Okay, the Duvets. Do you play original songs?
No, just covers.
I tell you what, that punchline we've been working up to, but one kid out there said, I've heard of the Duvets, I've got it on the bed. Well done, man. You were funnier than me then. I've been working hard on this. Well done, maybe we're right. He was right, a comedy genius, that's what he is. Listen,
yeah, I'm still here, Steve.
I'm sorry to ignore you. So Rod's going to play some blues music tonight, and what's the name of your first song?
It's called Ventriloquist Dunner Blues. Turn on the guitar, man. Cheers, dude.
That's it. So, Rod? Yeah, is this the biggest room you've ever worked?
No, it's the quietest.
No, listen, this is an electric audience, right? So, is this the biggest room?
No, have you heard of the O2?
The O2 in London?
Yeah.
You've worked the O2?
Uh-huh.
And was it sold out?
It was the Ed Sheeran.
What?
I was working the toilets.
Oh.
You gotta start somewhere, dude.
Yes, you do. So, is there anyone that we would have heard of that you have worked with?
Have you heard of the Stones?
Yeah.
Do you want to hear some Stones?
Everly Brothers. They call the Everly Brothers?
No, the Alcohol and the Everly Sisters.
Why is that?
It's easier for you.
Okay, so this is a song by the Everly Brothers.
You're going to join in?
You can't join in. Can't duet. I'm not a singer. So,
okay, turn up the guitar. Thank you, dude.
Lockdowns last year or the year before, and so you're going to do that for us now?
Yeah, a cappella.
A cappella. So no music, so are you ready?
Yeah.
And what's the song called?
It's called I Dug a Hole for You.
What? Your girlfriend?
Yeah, she's jolly nuts.
No, sing the song.
Hey honey, I dug a hole for you. Get in. I dug you a hole, can you dig it? You don't need to dig it, because I dug it. Can you dig it? Because I dug it. Can you dig it? Because I dug it. Get in the hole. I dug you a hole, get in the hole. Get in there!
Robert, it's for your girlfriend.
Yeah.
But it's not very romantic.
No, but it is really deep.
Ladies and gentlemen, Rob Vegas. Can I get it, love it? I've had this character in my act for 28 years. And it was passed down to me by a legend of the business who worked at Butlins for many years and loved him here at Butlins. And it was my idol, and then we became really close and we were really good friends. And I keep this character in the act just so I can remember my very good friend, the wonderful Mr. Keith Harris. And he invented Orville, he invented Cuddles the Monkey, and he invented Pongo the Skunk. Okay.
me, that doesn't look really pasty.
We've now gone all the way home. This is the audience.
Hello! I'm a skunk!
Pongo's a skunk?
Yeah,
your act sticks. Pongo's gonna entertain. So, if you're on stage, you have to have versatility.
I got versatility.
Okay, you have to do jokes.
Yeah,
yeah.
Why did the chicken crisscross the road?
Don't know.
His hands were stuck up the chicken.
Not that one. No, but it was, wasn't it? It was, actually. So, but I did cross the road. With that, I've done it in front of microphones now. So, look forward
to the end after that joke.
Look forward. Right, so, Pongo's going to do a little song for you.
Mary had a little lamb, she fed it Jacob's crackers. Eddie Tyler dropped her crumbs, she kicked it.
No, listen. You're not listening. You're going to entertain.
Entertain?
Yes. You do impressions.
Oh, I do.
So you said you were learning impressions. Who was you learning?
Donald Trump.
The ex president.
Yeah.
You can't do Donald Trump.
I can't.
You can't do Donald Trump. And I know that for a fact because if I learnt the voice, he might be able to do Donald Trump. I don't know if you get me, but if I can't do it, he can't do it. So because I don't know how to do the voice, and so he can't do the impression of Donald Trump. So we'll have to do something else. Let me think of something else.
And do Donald Trump.
So, you can't do it. You can't do it.
It's this one. I'm doing his hair. He's standing under a helicopter.
Yeah, so what am I going to do instead? No, what?
Steve, look! Look how you're the next killer name.
What are you doing? Why don't you do Boris Johnson?
Same hair. Peter, how's it going? What's wrong with that?
Listen.
Don't sneak out of parties.
No.
Sneak out to the shop and get a cone.
Listen to me. So,
Good to work. Stay home. Work from home. Don't get to work. Good to work. Let's stay home when you go to work. Don't go to the party. Then go to the party. Let's see that you didn't go to the party.
Oh, listen. So, instead, right, you're going to introduce the final guest because we do have to move on. Yeah? You have to say good night. You're introduce the next guest.
No. So you don't understand, Steve. I'm the end.
Sorry?
I am the end, the star of the show.
Mm-hmm.
Not anymore. You used to be, you know, when I started out, you used to be, then Arthur Larkin came along, kind of took over, so he's. You're not the end of the show anymore. There's someone else who's going to come out, she's going to sing.
Lift up my hand.
Pardon?
Lift up my hand. Why don't we just do it? It's not effective. Oh! I'm like an actor.
All right.
I should have gone to Rada. I could be an EastEnders. Oi! Get out now, pal! Ponga.
Oh! Ponga, you're not crying.
I'm crying!
You're not.
I'm crying!
You're not crying.
How do you know?
There's no tears.
That's it, then, is it?
Yeah.
You are the one that created me.
But you are the second generation Pongo, and when I ordered you, I thought I got it right.
Well, you didn't. There's no tear ducts. I can't cry.
Duh. Oh, Danny.
Ladies and gentlemen. What are you doing now?
Tear ducts? I'll make me Anna. And while we're here talking about the lack of movement,
yeah,
and I don't mean constipation.
No, I don't know. What do you mean?
Got no eyelids. I've actually been asleep the whole time I've been on, and you didn't know. I've got no eyelids. I haven't slept since 1998.
don't be shouting.
Does it hurt your throat?
So listen, right?
Yeah,
Pongo, just introduce the next guest. Yes, you do have to. Yes. She's going to come out and sing. She's a very special guest.
Well, I know it's not Adele, because she won't be ready.
I don't know, come on. Please welcome Tiny Tina!
Thank you.
God, look at the state of that. Hello, are you Chucky's sister? Stop it. Oh, good God, look. Oh, it's still that. What's it all about? Now, see? Oh, so leave her alone. That's Tiny Tina. Look at that dog. Okay, she's going to sing a lovely little song. This morning, I asked Pongo for the finale tonight. I asked Pongo to teach Tina a song. Did you teach her a song this morning? Good. And was it the song I asked you to teach her?
No.
Was it the song I asked you to teach her?
No.
Was it the song I asked you to teach her, Pongo?
That's a nice girl.
Right, I'm gonna count to 10. Why? I don't know, I said mum's doing supermarkets, and by the time they get to 10, the kids are hung up. So I'll count to 10. What supermarket are you in? Morrison's, okay? What if I'm in Waitrose? Well, they just count to 3 in Waitrose, and they talk really sophisticatedly, and then they just walk out the shop without buying anything. They'll probably go and order online or something. Steve, what? Just, what are you going to count to? I count to 5. Where are you? Tesco's? Just get on with it. One? What's the question? Did you teach her a naughty song this morning? I can't believe you can do that at the same time. You should have come second. Listen. If this is a rude song, you're going straight in the box. I'll take the money. There's no money in the box. It's not a game show. Okay, so this is a lovely song from Tiny Tina. She's going to sing it now. Mary had a little watch. She swallowed it one day. Her doctor gave the castor oil to pass the time away. Was that the song you taught Tina? No. It wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be. I ain't finished it yet. What? A castor oil did not work, the watch it did not come. If you want to know the time, just look up Mary's eye. It's not your song. He's asked for the music. Oh, not this frozen cack. Don't be rude. This frozen one and frozen two. What's that called? Defrosted.
Snow falls white on the mountains tonight. No footprint to be seen. A kingdom of isolation, and it looks like I'm the queen. The wind is howling like this swirling storm inside. Couldn't keep it in.
What are you doing? Sound effects. We don't need howling. Shut up.
Let them in.
Don't let her sing.
Be the good girl I've always had to be. Conceal, don't feel, don't let them know. And now they know. Let it go.
Let her go. I can't stand that singing anymore.
Let it go. Let it go.
Just shut her face in the door. No, go home, Sunita, come on, go home. Ah, ah, I'm dancing in Skegness. Ah, 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 ah,
stay the line, stay the line.
Ah, ah, ah,
ah. My God, my God, no.
No, no.
Yeah, I've had enough.
Had enough?
Yeah.
Same time tomorrow?
Why? So yeah, I get paid.
You get paid, yeah. She's under the table, thanks. You know, I'm doing up to side now. Okay, listen. Why are you being so half-hearted?
Half-hearted?
No. I said you're being half-hearted.
You said half-hearted.
I said half-hearted.
Half-hearted?
No. I said you're half-hearted. I didn't.
What?
You said half-hearted. Listen, one more time.
Half-hearted!
He didn't move your mouth then. It was her. She farted. No, Pongo! Look over there.
Who is it?
No, I mean, just concentrate, because you're going to sing a little song, and they're going to clap their hands. Oh, excellent.
It's it.
Here's that. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, you've been amazing. Thank you so much for coming out to see the show. It makes my journey. It's a long drive, but it's always worth it. And the audience is as good as you. Thank you so much. And if you see me walking about Butlins at any time, please come up and say hello. But if I am talking to myself, don't go near me because it means I'm in a staff meeting. Oh, I should have started with that one. And just quickly, I want to tell you a little story. This story was when I was 12 years old in 1987. I was watching the Royal Variety performance with my family. And I said to my mum, because I just started learning ventriloquism, I said, I want to be on that show. And she said, Steve, if you believe in yourself, work hard, and don't ever give up, you will be on that show. And I believed her. So, I was 12 years old then. 10 years later, I turned professional. I was 22, started to do holiday parks all over the country, and I worked cruise ships all over the world. And then it was amazing because I got to my big break. Because I was watching the Royal Variety Show all through my 20s and my 30s, and I hadn't been on the show. And I was watching it to see if I was on it. And every time I watched it, I wasn't on it. And so I was waiting for that phone call from ITV, like we all do as entertainers. And in January 2013, I had a phone call from ITV. And they said, Steve, if you come and audition at the London Palladium next week for Britain's Got Talent, they said, if you win that show, you will be on the Royal Variety as a prize. That's all I needed to hear because I could hear my mum's voice telling me that I could do it. And I'm only telling you because the boys and girls here, they never forget little nuggets that they're told. Don't give up. Believe in yourself and work really hard, kids. And even if your grandparents are in between, just don't ever give up on your dream. You can still do it. Believe in yourself. And I'm telling you that for a reason, Butlins Skegness, because if you watch the Royal Variety performance this Christmas, 2022, I am going to be at home watching it as well. Some of this is comedy, it's not all factual. Ladies and gentlemen, you've been lovely. Have a safe journey and look after yourselves and be nice. Good night, thank you. Cheers.